Yo, what's good, everybody? So I want you to take a walk with me back in time to summer 16. Some of us might know that as the year of Sanji. At this point, I need you to smash that like button. Make sure you're subscribed. Sit back, relax. We're going to be talking about the man, the myth, the champagne pappy himself, Blackleg Sanji. Let's get into it. So let's talk about this man, Sanji, man. And specifically why Sanji is the Drake of One Piece.
Drake?
That's right. I said it. He is the Drake of One Piece. Now, a lot of y'all are looking at me like, Sifu, what are you talking about? Well, allow me to explain. First off, Sanji's a ladies' man. There's no doubt about that. Sanji is a ladies' man. Big, old, young, small. He loves them all. Even furries, even a girl with a third eye. I mean, that should tell you everything you need to know. I mean, this is a guy that going into Fishman Island almost died for having perverted thoughts about mermaids.
And this man is a simp, bro. I mean, come on, dude. Whole Cake Island, this man is outside on the porch crying. I mean, don't get me wrong. After Whole Cake Island, we know that Sanji is definitely more in tune with, like, his emotions and his feminine side and all that. And that's cool. I mean, that's part of the reason why we love him, right? I'm just saying there's one way to describe it, and that is a simp. And there's a couple of times, me personally, I just want to be like, yo, Sanji, bro, you're better than this. Come on now, snap out of it. And let's not get it twisted. Women love Sanji as well. Let's go back to Zou when he figured out the gotta chew thing and he's running around the whole island rubbing cheeks with all the ladies. I mean, Sanji definitely knows what he's doing, okay? He'll spit game to a woman and he'll treat them right. Let's take Pudding for example. She starts out the arc, you know, she's, how do you say, bat crazy, right? She wants to kill Sanji, but by the end of the arc, he's made her do a complete 180 in terms of the way that she sees him. She no longer wants to kill him. She actually loves him by the end of the arc. It breaks her heart for her to erase his memories of him kissing her, right? Because she loves him so much. And that's just it. Sanji has a way with women that the rest of the Straw Hats and, dare I say, everybody else in the series does not have. And this could be where all the hate comes from. You know what I'm saying? He definitely has more game than Duval or Django with the moonwalk. Yonji, Niji, Ichiji, definitely all his brothers. That's facts. That's canon. Sanji has more games than all his brothers.
He definitely battles self-doubt and it doesn't always work out. But that brings me to my next point. Sanji wins and Sanji loses. Now, let me explain. In everything in Sanji's life, it's almost like he reflects a real person. In some scenarios, he takes one step forward and three steps back. There's a win and there's a loss. With women, he spends the majority of the series chasing women. But the one time a woman was willing to chase him in Pudding, the one time he was actually able to get married, he had to let that go. He won and he lost. And this man's been taking L's his whole life. I mean, his mother died, his father hated him, he had to run away from his kingdom, but he eventually found a father figure in Zeth and family in the Baratie and eventually the Straw Hats. He lost, then he won. This is even illustrated in fights and clashes that Sanji takes place in. And I know it drives the fan base insane, but Sanji loses a lot of clashes. I mean, an absurd amount of clashes. For somebody who's the third strongest on the crew, he's lost clashes against Judge, Niji, Virgo, Doffy, Oven and Daifuku. That's a gray area. The anime did it a little bit different. And I would say he's won against Jabra, Wadatsume, and Queen. I mean, Queen is obviously not done yet, but we know that it's coming. But still, the record's not really that great. I would definitely say Sanji's the type of person that can lose a clash or lose the battle, but win the war. I mean, when it comes down to it, Jabra, Queen, Wadatsumi, he gets the job done. Sanji ain't no slouch. He's the third strongest on the crew. He uses both forms of haki, both observation and armament haki. And that means he can match up with a lot of the top tier people in the series. The only issue is when sometimes he slips and falls on his face. Like when he takes on Virgo or Doflamingo and his leg ends up cracking in the middle of the battle. I mean, it almost doesn't make any sense, dude. You fight with your feet. Why is someone like Virgo able to crack your leg? This type of thing was happening all over Whole Cake. As a matter of fact, Whole Cake during the year of Sanji was supposed to be, in my opinion, a showcase for Sanji, and he practically did almost nothing. And no, we are not going to count baking a cake as a win. We are not accepting that around here. Sanji really needed a one-on-one during Whole Cake to showcase his ability, to showcase what he could bring to the new world, and he really never got it. He had some clashes with his family, he had some clashes with Oven and Daifuku that were, you know, generally a stalemate, and Sanji never really got to showcase his ability at all. He baked a cake and he escaped with Luffy. And One Piece ain't only about battles, it's about characters. It's about world building. It's about adventure. It's about the costume design. Now, let me hold you there for a second. Oda's a man, like myself, who loves costume design. I mean, these characters switch costumes almost every arc multiple times. And the facts are, Sanji got that drip, bro. Sanji is definitely the flyest person in One Piece. There's absolutely no doubt about that. I mean, the man be having the suits, he be having the little cigarette. Sometimes he got the black gloves. Looking like the dude from Hitman. I mean, I love characters like that. Super fly shooters, essentially. You know, like James Bond or something. Whenever Oda wants to showcase somebody great in One Piece, they're usually depicted with a captain's jacket, like sort of draped over their shoulders, but not Sanji. Sanji got a cape. He's the only person in One Piece to make a cape look cool. Lord Sanji definitely has all the swagger. I mean, he made his wedding tuxedo look fly. And I'm not even gonna get started on his movie attire. You think Sanji looks cool in the anime? In the movies, he steps his game up even higher. I mean, his One Piece gold outfit? Let me stop. I mean, he's so fly, he can actually fly. We all dropped our jaws when we saw him pull out the Skywalk. I mean, some people call it the moonwalk, but it's whatever you want to call it. It was tight. But anyway, Sanji, absolute flyest dude in One Piece, hands down. My next point is, everyone loves to hate Sanji. Just like everybody loves to hate Drake, everybody loves to hate Sanji. I mean, I think hashtag Lanji was trending for a year after Whole Cake. That's definitely due in part to the way Oda's portrayed him. I don't think that's any fault of Sanji himself, but you can't doubt how strong he is, can't doubt his success. I mean, Sanji is clearly the third strongest person on the crew. He will find the All Blue, he'll make Luffy the Pirate King. He ditched his Vince Moke family, found a new family, actually got married and turned it down. There's no doubting that Sanji, by the end of the story, will have achieved everything that he wants. But yet, half of the fan base still loves to hate on him. At this point, it's almost like an event that happens every year where the fan base gets an outrage about how they don't like Sanji or they don't like the way Sanji is portrayed. But they need to chill out, man. Listen, Sanji is a heavy hitter in this pirate game. I'm not even gonna speak on what his bounty is gonna look like post Wano. His bounty post Whole Cake, that was nothing. That was weak. A little 330 million. That ain't really what Sanji's worth. He's about to take down a billion plus bounty person. So post Wano, all that talking gonna have to stop. Luffy needs Sanji. He went all the way to Whole Cake Island, started a fight with another Yonko that he didn't need to start a fight with to get Sanji. Our Pirate King knows what's up. Sanji is a nice guy.
with a heart of gold until you piss him off. Then it's curtains. But Sanji is the man. He's Chef Curry with the wrist, Mr. Top 2 and he's not 2, the new certified lover boy. Put some respect on his name. This is the Lord, the legend, Prince Vince Smoke Sanji. First of his name, the blackleg, finder of the all. Let me stop. I'm not even going to get into all that. Listen, I'd like to thank everybody for listening to me rant about Sanji today. I mean, Sanji is our guy. We know we love Sanji, flaws and all, and he's definitely the flyest person in One Piece. But this is just a quick character analysis and a quick comparison as to why Sanji is essentially the Drake of One Piece. So if you like the video, please smash the like button. Make sure you comment. And hey, give me an idea on what character I should do next, what character comparison I should do next. I'm pretty sure I've got an idea of a couple I could do at least. So definitely make sure you subscribe. Make sure you hit the little bell so you get the notification when I put up a new video. Stay safe, stay healthy, and I will catch you guys next time.
And I never been embraced, and the money's hard to make, so I bet they on their face right now. When he tell the story, that's not how I went. Know they be lying 100%. Moved out of risk and forgot about the bit. Why they just called me to tell me come get it? Now that boy off and I don't want no credit. If it was me, they wouldn't regret it. Left me for dead and now they won't edit.